gardeners, welcome to another video on my channel. My name is Trisha for anyone that's new, and today we are going to be talking about stress and reptiles. We're going to talk about why reptiles get stressed, how to deal with it, and how to tell if they're stressed in the first place. So hopefully this video will be helpful for someone because there are so many different situations where reptiles get stressed. Yes, Chacho, I'm sorry, he wants me to throw his ball. But reptiles get stressed all the time because of so many different reasons, and it's very important to learn your animal, understand when they're stressed and how you can correct it. So this video will include some tips and tricks and just ways to understand your reptile's behavior, because not everyone is familiar with reptiles. I'm just gonna keep throwing the ball as this video goes on, so I hope that's not weird. But a lot of people just aren't very familiar, so they may not understand when their reptile is stressed. So hopefully this video can help you guys get a better idea. But of course, if you're working with your reptile for a long time, you're going to start to pick up on these things and realize when your animal is stressed. So the first thing that we're going to talk about today is what makes reptiles stressed. So like I mentioned, there are so many different situations that can be stressful for reptiles. So one of the most common things that's stressful for reptiles is when you first bring them home and you're putting them into a completely new environment. This is just very stressful for reptiles because they don't know what's going on. They don't know if they're safe. They just feel vulnerable, and that is just very stressful for them. So that's like the number one thing when you're buying a new animal, whether you're having it shipped to your house or you're picking it up from a store or a show. Any type of new environment is going to be stressful for your animal. Another thing that can be stressful for reptiles is improper husbandry. So this includes maybe having the wrong temperatures. Sorry, I have to grab this ball. Humidity, lack of hides, basically anything that's required in their enclosure that isn't on point. Because when you're keeping a reptile, you want to try to replicate their habitat that they have in the wild, basically in your house in captivity. And if you're not doing this correctly, it's very stressful for the animal. Another thing that can cause stress for reptiles is handling and interaction. So typically, reptiles don't desire to have relationships with humans. They don't actively go out of their way to ever go near a human or just have that interaction, especially in the wild. Although when you're keeping reptiles in captivity, they do learn to trust you, and some of them actually do tolerate the handling really well to a point where it seems like they enjoy it and they want it. But for a lot of reptiles, it's very stressful because maybe you haven't built that bond with them yet, and maybe it's just new territory and it's a new animal and the handling just isn't going very well and it's stressful for them. So later on in the video, I'm going to talk about ways to overcome this, but it definitely is going to happen where a reptile doesn't want to be handled, and that's just a stressful situation for them because it's just a matter of them not feeling safe and not really trusting the person that's handling them. Something else that can stress reptiles out is cohabitation. So cohabitation is when you are putting a reptile in an enclosure and then putting another reptile in there with them, whether it's the same species or a different species, which is just really, really bad. You don't want to put two reptiles of a different species in an enclosure. I've done an entire video on cohabitation because it is something that is very controversial. Some people do it. I just think that it's better to keep all of your animals separate, because when you're cohabitating reptiles, I think the word is actually cohabiting. I don't know why I always think it's cohabitating, but that's not the word. I looked it up before. But basically, when you're keeping more than one animal in an enclosure, it does cause stress because there's a lack of hides. There's gonna be competition for food and hides and space. And it's stressful for them. So that's one of the reasons I kind of go against it, but this video is not about cohabitation. So I'm just bringing up the fact that it can cause stress in reptiles. So now that we know some situations that may cause stress to your reptiles, it's important to be able to tell if they're stressed in the first place. So there are different behaviors that reptiles show that indicate if they're stressed or not. So one of the main ways to tell that your reptile is stressed is a lack of appetite or not eating. So that's mainly the number one thing, because any reptile that's under stress is not going to eat. They may not feel safe, or maybe something just isn't right in their enclosure. They're going to be stressed out, and that is the number one indication that they're stressed, is if they're not eating. Another behavior to keep an eye on is a lack of activity, So this can be a little bit more confusing and may be easier to detect with someone that's more familiar with their reptile and have had them for a while, because a lot of reptiles are nocturnal and they are not active whatsoever during the day. So it's important if you have a nocturnal species to just check on them at night, see if they're active or not. A lot of animals are just not very active during the day, and that's perfectly fine. It doesn't mean that they're stressed out. But if you do notice your activity level in your animal used to be a certain way and then they're behaving differently and they're less active and they aren't really exploring their enclosure like they used to, it could be because they're stressed. And then the third and most obvious way to tell if your reptile is stressed is through basically them communicating and being very defensive towards you. So a lot of the times people will call this aggression. I like to call it defense because they're just trying to protect themselves because they feel in danger. And some of the things are very obvious and it's like clearly your animal is stressed out if it's doing these things. But some of these things include hissing, obviously, if your animal is trying to bite you, if your animal is changing color. Chameleons get really dark. They may get like polka dots on it. If it's a veiled chameleon, that means they're really stressed out. Bearded dragons, of course, puff up their beard and then it turns black. Any animal that's puffing itself up and trying to appear larger is under stress and it's trying to protect itself. It feels like it's in danger. And then, of course, there's tail whipping. Iguanas love to do this. My beardie has actually done this to me. Like, it was like a weak little whip, but he's done it before too when he's stressed out and I'm picking him up. But these are all different things that reptiles will do basically as a communication to you, letting you know that they're big and scary and don't mess with them. And obviously it just means that they're just really stressed out in those situations because they aren't comfortable and relaxed. If your animal is in a calm state, that's really reassuring and great to know that your animal is not stressed in that moment. But if it's having these little defensive behaviors, it's stressed out. So now that we know what can cause stress and how to detect it, now let's talk about ways to reduce their stress levels, because it's so important to make sure that reptiles aren't stressed, because stress can affect them in their health and well-being. As human beings, we don't like being stressed out, and it goes the same thing for reptiles as well. Stress is just not healthy for their well-being. So some ways to reduce the stress level in your animal is to, number one, make sure that your husbandry is on point. This means that you have the proper temperatures, the proper humidity, there's enrichment in your enclosure, there's hides, there's foliage. Basically, just do as much as you possibly can to make sure that they not only have the basic fundamental needs to survive, but you also want them to thrive in that environment as well. So if you're doing all of this, it's a great way to reduce stress. If you just stick an animal in an empty tank and call it a day, they are going to be very, very stressed out. They are not going to know what's going on. So it's just very important to make sure that your husbandry is always on point. So the second way to reduce stress for your reptile is basically to just have a routine when you do things. And when I say routine, I don't say like maybe have a cleaning schedule or feeding schedule. I'm saying have a routine of your approach. So this basically means that when you're approaching your reptile, you should always be doing it in the same way. Keep a routine. Whether you're misting, turning lights on and off, going to feed, you want your animal to learn your body movements and your behaviors and start to trust that and realize that you're not a threat, and they will start to trust you. By being able to do this, you can form a relationship with them and they will learn to trust you, and it will reduce their stress levels significantly. I have a wild caught skink, and he does not like handling whatsoever, so that's not something I do with him. But he used to always run away from me and just want nothing to do with me. Whenever he saw me, he was running away and hiding. And I was able to establish a relationship with him through feeding eventually, and now he comes right up to the glass when he's hungry and he knows I'm gonna feed him. So it's just a matter of routine and keeping things in check so that way they can learn you and how you're going to approach them and do things with them on a daily basis and learn to trust that routine. Number three would be to give them time to adjust if you're just bringing them home for the first time. As I mentioned before, bringing a new reptile home can be very stressful for them because it's a new environment. So within that first week, whatever reptile it is, you want to give them an adjustment period, meaning no handling, let them settle in. You of course want your enclosure to be fully set up by the time you bring the animal home. That way you can just place it in the enclosure and it can start to adjust. By giving them time and not handling them and stressing them out, obviously are going to be reducing their stress levels because they're just going to have time to adjust and learn to feel secure and safe in their new environment. And the fourth way to reduce stress in reptiles, that was really a great throw. The fourth way to reduce stress in reptiles is the most basic thing of all, and you should be doing this no matter what, and that is to be respectful when handling your reptiles. So in the reptile community, I notice people doing things all of the time that kind of stress out their animals, whether they're doing it for their own good or whatever the case may be. People mishandle and like manhandle their reptiles. They like stressing them out for like cute pictures or whatever the case may be. It's not fair to the reptile, and that is not going to establish a good relationship with you and your reptile. So you just always need to be respectful when you take your animal out. Again, you want to be approaching them in a confident way, but you don't want to be like grabbing them and snatching them and potentially harming them. And then obviously stressing them out by doing that. You just want to be very kind and supportive. Always make sure that you're fully supporting your reptile's body. If they're really stressed out, they're going to be obviously hissing and tail whipping and things. So if you're going to be taming a reptile down in that way, you should just do little handling sessions that are just maybe like 10 minutes long, 5 or 10 minutes. You can increase the time each day. People always ask me, how often should I handle my reptile that I'm trying to tame down? I would say maybe just start off maybe once a week, then a couple times a week, then a few times a week. And every single time you're going to be doing it in little increments. You just don't want to overstress your animal because that's not going to establish a good relationship either. So you just want them to eventually learn that handling is okay. You're being respectful of them. You are not a threat. You're not harming them. And then that will help to reduce their stress levels significantly. And then over time, they may tolerate the handling really great, and they may even enjoy it in time as well. So these are just some ways to just be aware of stress in reptiles, because it is something that is very, very common. These animals are so unlike humans, and sometimes it's hard for humans to understand how they are, the way that they think, their needs, and their stress levels. So it's just something to be aware of to make sure that you're able to give them, again, the best life possible with you in captivity. So I hope that this video was helpful. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video.